I'm Cal Mahesh, Strategic Marketing Director for Battery Gauging. This is a high-level overview of gauges and the importance of them in your design. What is a gauge and why do you need it? Let's start with a visual. Typically, a lithium-ion battery discharge curve goes from 4.2 volts full to 3 volts empty. Suppose we're at the midpoint of the discharge. A gauge's job is to predict which route the battery is going to take. What is the remaining capacity at the current load, and how long can the battery run? The answer varies based on the load current and temperature. It could be the orange line at the lowest discharge rate with the most runtime, or the green line with the highest discharge rate providing the least runtime. The gauge's job is to measure voltage, current, temperature, and predict the battery's remaining capacity and runtime. There are primarily two ways of measuring capacity: voltage lookup and current integration, compensating, of course, for temperature effects. To know how the voltage lookup method works, imagine the battery as this straight glass. The amount of water is measured by the level in the glass, and pouring water into the glass is like charging the battery. There are two challenges with the voltage lookup method. To be accurate, the water level should be read only after water settles and there is no ripple. In the same way, one can make accurate measurement of capacity based on voltage lookup only on a well-rested battery. That is, a device in sleep mode and does not allow for gauging on an actively used device. The second challenge is the lookup table itself. A capacitor is similar to the straight glass with a linear curve for voltage, while a battery has a nonlinear curve and is more like this martini glass. You can see water level changes nonlinearly and rises faster at the bottom and more slowly at the top. Now let's see how the current integration method works. Current integration works by keeping track of how much water you pour in and take out of an imaginary spout. Similarly, changes in capacity are monitored by tracking how much charge goes in and out of a battery. While you know the changes in capacity, the first challenge is how to translate that to a full and empty measurement. In other words, you need a mechanism to sync at the top and bottom. The second challenge here is accounting for self-discharge. Think of water evaporating slowly and not flowing out of the spout. How do you account for this water evaporation or battery self-discharge? The third challenge is the effects of temperature. Depending on how hot or cold it gets after the water is poured in, the amount of water you put in may not be equal to the amount of water you're able to get out. TI's battery fuel gauges solve these complex issues through superior data acquisition hardware combined with superior algorithms. The first algorithm is the CEDV, compensated end of discharge voltage method, where current integration is employed for gauging, and to overcome the sink issue we discussed earlier, towards the end of discharge, the voltage thresholds corresponding to 7% and 3% remaining state of charge are calculated in real time based on load and temperature, and the user is alerted prior to the battery reaching zero. There is a complex formula that takes into account self-discharge and temperature effects. This method, of course, relies on learning full charge capacity by discharging the battery below 7%, at least occasionally. The second algorithm is impedance track. It has the well-rested voltage lookup information called open circuit voltage, or OCV, and from this curve, it tracks usable capacity based on the load and battery resistance. This algorithm combines the benefits of voltage correlation and Coulomb counting. It uses voltage correlation when the battery is well-rested and uses Coulomb counting under load. Thus, it provides the best of both worlds and delivers the highest accuracy. For more details about gauges, why you need them, product information, samples and evaluation modules, please visit www.ti.com/batterygauging. Thank you for your time today.